Andy Mendoza here with head coach, with Amherst head coach Jon Thompson. And coach, tough start to the game, obviously getting down early. But what was the message at halftime that really propelled you guys in that third period, an 8-2 period, and really made it a game?
Yeah, we clearly didn't come out the way we would have liked to, and credit RIT for sort of putting the boots to us in the first quarter. They did a really nice job off the ground. That has been one of our identities, is winning the ground and winning the wing ground ball battles, and we just didn't do that in the first quarter. And then when they locked that penalty in and we had we gave up four man down penalties back to back to back to back. That helped their run quite a bit. And so we went into halftime. It was nothing magical that I said. It was just the guys sort of made a decision and said, hey, either this game's going to go one of two ways. That's what I just told our guys in the locker room, just how proud of them I am just for the fight they showed in that third quarter. We got a good group, and, we spent all of our energy getting it to 14-13, fail to clear. And you sort of just felt the air come out of the ball a little bit. And I thought our goalie played pretty well this game, which had been something that we've been focused on a little bit. So it sort of is always a great lacrosse game with RIT, and unfortunately we came out on the wrong end of it this year.
And what do you credit the resiliency of your team? I mean, really, when you're down, like you said, as much as you guys were in that first half, it's easy to kind of fold up the 10 and just say, we'll live to fight another day. But you guys fought back, made it a game, like you said, got within one, and then for the rest of the way kind of just traded goals back and forth. What do you credit that resilience and that fight?
Yeah, leadership is my first answer. Dylan Finazzo at the faceoff stripe, I think, may be the best in the country. And so he allows us to play the way that we want to play, and that's getting up there into the high teens and the low 20s, and so he really did a nice job of stepping up. And then Jimmy McAfee on the wings and Jordan Sanford on the wings, we really just got back to being us a little bit. You started winning some wing ground balls, and we just got back to being us and caring a little bit less about our opponent and caring more about ourselves. And I think when we do that, we're a tough out for anybody. And unfortunately, today we only did that for about three quarters. And RIT certainly had something to do with that.
And what can you say about the game that Jackson Herrick had? Four goals. Some of them were really fantastic individual efforts. What can you say about his performance today and what he can do moving forward also for you guys?
Yeah, he's a really good athlete, isn't he? It's fun watching him dodge. He's also shoots the ball with really, really good velocity. And, I think he got one. It might have been his first one where he came back to his left. And he got one there that really sort of got a monkey off his back. And then after that, he just started rolling. And, that makes it a little bit of a tough out in terms of who are you going to put the long stick on. Is it Solberg or is it Herrick? And I thought Jackson did a really nice job of capitalizing on that and getting to spots where he had all four corners of the net to shoot at. And when the ball's going 98 miles an hour and you got four corners, it makes it a little more difficult on a goalie.
Sure, yeah. And obviously didn't get the outcome you wanted today, but big win yesterday. 1-1 on the weekend. What do you take from this weekend in terms of positives moving forward for the rest of the season?
First of all, the Stevenson organization, just the way that they put this event on, I'm really grateful for being a part of it. It's completely professional. It's certainly the best Division III event going, and the elite of the elite are here, and so to get a chance to play against these two teams who happen to be 1-2 in the country is really, really great. I'm not so certain how different they are from our league. The league that we face on a regular basis with however many top 20 teams, 6 or 8 or whatever it may be, at any time, it prepares us well for May. And coming up on 7 days from now, we got one of those teams. So I'm looking forward to seeing how this pans out. But back-to-back games, certainly if we're fortunate enough to play in the NESCAC semifinals and finals, certainly prepares us for May.
Thanks so much for the time, Coach. Good luck the rest of the way. Appreciate it.
Thank you very much.
For more coverage on the Mustang Classic, you can go to GoMustangSports.com.